views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Welcome to Shine On Radio. Find your shine with Kelly Wadler. You're tuned into the hit show that celebrates what makes you, you. Join Kelly as she breaks down how to brilliantly fuel and move your body and love what makes you shine. Kelly is a professional arts and wellness coach dedicated to helping brilliant women find their confidence, energy, and self-love. Now, get ready to shine with your host, Kelly Wadler.
Hello, everyone. Happy Monday. We're here again. We're here every Monday at 12 p.m. Eastern Time, 9 a.m. Pacific, and we have an awesome show for you today. I'm your host, Kelly Wadler. I am the founder of Shine On Movement, which is an arts and wellness coaching services company who believes that we all should be celebrating what makes us who we are and all those little fun things that make you uniquely you. One of my big components and foundations points in Shine On Movement is this idea of body positivity. And what that means to love the skin that you're in. Because from what I learned in my story and my upbringing within my body was this isn't the easiest thing to do. It isn't the easiest thing in the world to be in love with the body that you call your own, because there's a lot of other outside factors that are convincing you otherwise, convincing you that you are less than or that your body isn't the ideal. And when you grow up, especially as a young girl, young woman, you can be very easily susceptible to believing that is so. For me, I was a dancer, and I was a dancer since a little girl. And I watched my body change so quickly after an injury that in my own field at that time, I felt immediately too big. I all of a sudden was like, okay, you have a chest. No, you cannot be a dancer. Or the idea of looking at myself in the mirror with a leotard on was practically torture for me at that age, because I had been taught a dancer should look like this. So I was dealing with that then, and then, you know, found a little bit of a safe space in the theater world, which unfortunately didn't last so long, because once I got my BFA in college, I still felt that even more so, that feeling heightened in terms of, you know, your body should look this or that. In the acting world, it's like either you're skinny or you're bigger, but it's really hard to be in between. And I'm a good old size 10 gal, and I love it. But I really struggled loving it for a very long time. So luckily, however, we are in this new age of the body positive movement, and there are great positive things about it, as hence the title, and there are some not so great things about it, because everybody has their opinion, and we're going to really dive into all of that juicy stuff today. I have two awesome guests. Yes, two. It's a special day today. I have the founders of the Body Poscast here, which is a podcast that is dedicated to body positivity and dedicated to kind of being raw and truthful about what this movement is and what it really means to love the skin you're in and how you do it. There's two founders. One is Lillian Bussell, and she has been an activist for body positivity since she was 14. She is in burlesque. She's done a TED talk about stripping away negative body image, which has had over 100,000 views on YouTube. And she's a total rock star. Also, we have Liza, who is an actress, a singer, as she defines herself, a panda admirer. And also a big, big powerhouse when it comes to the body positive movement. So without further ado, ladies, welcome. Welcome to the show.
Hi, thanks for having us.
Hi, Kelly. It's great to be here.
Absolutely. Well, thank you for being here as well. So I start the show every time, and we can kind of do individual questions with this for the both of you. I ask each of my guests what in their life was the moment or the aha moment where they chose to follow their shine or chose to follow their light, let's say. Lila, you go, or Liza, you go first.
Oh, okay. Gosh, okay, that's a tough question because I really do feel like for me, there's not a moment of finding my shine. It's kind of a continuous thing. I have good days and I have bad days where I have days where I'm just like, yes, girl, my butt looks amazing. I'm excited to be wearing this dress and I just feel amazing. And then there are days where I cannot find anything to wear. And I think for me, it's about finding the balance and being okay with the days where I don't feel so great and knowing that tomorrow is a new day and I can find my shine all over again.
Beautiful. Lillian, how about you?
I came to burlesque not actually through the thought of becoming an activist with performance art. I came to burlesque because I wanted to perform femininity. I felt like I had so much like glamour inside of me as that I felt like I had had to repress because I had spent so much of my life trying not to be noticed. Like, and then I realized, because I'm a size 20 girl and I've been fat all my life. And I use that word as a self descriptor. And I felt like I was sort of denied the right to embrace my womanliness and my prettiness. Mm-hmm. And so through that, being able to use burlesque to sort of perform femininity and to be able to explore that element of who I felt I was, I've also been able to balance that with what I feel is beauty, which I think is different from prettiness, which is being able to value and respect myself even on days when I don't feel like aesthetically glorious, to be able to reach inside and be able to love myself even when I feel like I'm out of control with how I look, whether it's my hair or my skin or anything like that. So I like Liza said, I think that it's a process, but I think that my sparkle began when I grabbed up all those rhinestones and started doing burlesque.
Yeah. I mean, there is such a power to that and what you're both saying in that way that, yeah, it is a journey. But the key is how we find on those days when it seems like there isn't a sparkle to find miles and miles away, where we have to, though, cultivate that feeling of inner beauty. Because, correct me if I'm wrong, you know, one of the biggest beliefs I have is that when we don't feel good in our body, we aren't authentically who we are or want to be. When we are introducing ourselves or in the presence of other people, if we're so caught up in hiding or feeling ashamed about the physical size we take up, it's really challenging to then be genuinely who you are or express who you are in the way that you want to. So, answer me this. How in these days where it seems like I can't find an inch of beauty within myself, where do we start? How do we find it?
This is Lillian again. For me, I think it actually starts with a little bit of forgiveness.
Yeah.
to be able to accept the fact that despite what we see on social media with everybody posting all of their perfect stuff, that's a lot to live up to, and everybody's not perfect all the time. And to be able to just embrace yourself and sit with the, you know, get comfortable with the fact that every day is not going to be perfect, and you're going to have some days where you're not even going to want to leave the house, maybe.
Yeah. And I know for me, it's like those days where I don't feel great, what it really is about finding that part of me that is consistently optimistic.
Aww, yeah.
And it's just like tomorrow will be better, because I can certainly go down that rabbit hole. And I think that's for me what it is. It's like I'm on those days when I don't feel myself and I don't feel great. It's like, okay, but find that teeny tiny spark that's like, right, but tomorrow's a new day and tomorrow you will feel great. Because otherwise it'll just be weeks on end of I don't want to leave the house, and we can't have that.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it is recognizing that you have a choice, you know, that there is a choice to find, even if it doesn't seem that it's possible. There is a choice to start this process of self-love, or finding the little glimmer that is consistent within you and making that enough. When we get back, ooh la la, more on this topic, which you know I love, with these beautiful, beautiful women, Lillian and Liza. So when we get back, more with Shine On Radio and more with Body Positivity. See you in a second.
What is a master soul gardener? With Nomi Bahar, you can be one too. Her revolutionary Gates of Power method is a comprehensive program that addresses every aspect of yourself and gives you the tools to tend to the seeds of your soul's garden. Let Nomi guide you through and beyond what's holding you back and help you embrace the life you've always dreamed of. To learn more about upcoming classes and workshops, visit gatesofpower.com today.
Shine On Radio. Find Your Shine with Kelly is the show that celebrates what makes you, you. Join co-hosts Kelly Wadler and Dr. Pat Basile as they break down how to brilliantly fuel and move your body and love what makes you shine. Kelly is a professional arts and wellness coach dedicated to helping brilliant women find their confidence, energy, self-love, and shine. Tune in to Shine On Radio with Kelly and find your shine on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Francine Vail is a being of light. She believes that all people of planet Earth are as well. As co-host of the Angel Healer radio show, Francine teaches you heart-centered ways to manifest healing on your own behalf and how to integrate love more fully into your daily life. Connect with your angels as you find your life flowing with ease and harmony. Walk the path of light with Francine and Dr. Pat Basile every month on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Do you want the freedom to spend more time with your loved ones? Travel the world? Live spontaneously? Get ready, because the Chip Justice Show is here. Hosts Dr. Pat Basile and Chip Justice can help you build meaningful success while embracing life. Living a life you love is the end game in this new, inspirational, and empowering show. Positive changes for a life you'll love. Tune in every month on TransformationTalkRadio.com and visit PositiveChangeInstitute.co for more information.
A word of caution, if you prefer the status quo and you are not interested in improving every aspect of your life, this book will trigger the shift out of you. The Truth is Funny, Shift Happens is available now. Author Colette Steffen brings the powerful knowledge and life-changing energy and empowerment from the radio airwaves to the pages of her new book. To get your copy in paperback or ebook, visit thetruthisfunny.com today.
How would you like increased health and vitality? How would you like to avoid the onset of disease as well as slow the aging process? This is all possible through a simple, safe, and natural process. Every day, we are either moving toward wellness or away from wellness.
Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. I'd like to be your partner in achieving optimal health. Contact me now at MaryJaneMack.com or call 425-392-0659. Visit MaryJaneMack.com.
1230 WBLQ.
Producer Brian plays such happy, uplifting music. Thank you, Brian, again.
Awesome. You know what? I'm glad to do that because I love being happy, just like you and Lillian.
and Liza.
Yes. And you know what? There's no better time than, even though it's challenging to be happy midday on a Monday, you know what? That's why we're here on Shine On Radio to bring the light. And today we're doing just that with one of my favorite topics in the world, which is body positivity and the movement that we're seeing everywhere rise from our feet, that enough is enough. It is time to love the skin we're in, regardless of what shape it is, regardless of what the media and the fashion world tells us what is perfect and what is not, and love what we got, period. So today we have the founders of the Body Poscast, Liza and Lillian. Before we start re-diving in, ladies, tell us about your podcast and where and when and how we can get connected with you.
Yeah, sure. So our podcast is called the Body Poscast with an S, with a little play on words for everyone there. We have a website, which is www.thebodypodcast.com. And we're all up on social media under that same name. And, you know, we post as often as we can. We're, you know, a self-run operation here. And so basically, whenever we can get together and talk and record, and then I edit it together and I get it up as soon as we can for you guys.
Yeah. And if anybody out there who's listening has suggestions as far as things that they'd like to hear us talk about or people that they'd like for us to get in touch with to interview, you can reach us at bodypodcast@gmail.com. We'd love to hear from you.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. And I know that one of these days I'm going to be on there too. Can't wait.
Heck yeah.
Oh, I'm stoked. All right. So let's go back to diving in. So body positivity, it's a buzzword now. It's a hashtag now. You know, some people disagree with it. Do you know the woman I'm talking about who went on that rage on a YouTube or on a Periscope?
Yeah.
And she went on a rage pretty much that body positive is, you know, pretty much pro-obesity and pro-unhealthy lifestyle. And it couldn't be further from the truth. And that's what people seem to not understand. And so my little two cents about this is body positivity is, regardless of where you are in your transformation or not transformation or wherever you are in falling in love with the skin you're in, it's choosing to love that body now in the moment and seeing it for the magical gift, the work of art that it is. You cannot tell a person's health by their physical shape, period. And it's becoming this, you know, some controversy here. So let's dive into this. What does the body positive movement mean to you guys? And dare to dive into some of the backlash that you're seeing about it.
For me personally, I think that one of the essentials that really strikes home with me is the idea that we all deserve respect regardless of our health, mm-hmm. And that body positivity is about mental, emotional wellness, mm-hmm. and not about physical health at all.
Yeah.
I think that it's very ableist to come at a point of view, like to say that you only get to like yourself if you're healthy, because health means a lot of different things. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Liza.
Yeah. Health means a lot of different things, mental health and physical health. I think, funnily enough for me, body positivity almost has almost nothing to do with what you look like. Like, it's not about, it doesn't just apply to fat people or trans people or whatever. It's about being comfortable in your own skin and having other people, like you said, respect you for that and not tear you down because of what you look like. Yeah. So
I think that it also is, it's important for me from two angles. I'm mostly interested in reaching out to people to discuss the idea that you have some element of control as to how you react to things, and that the way that you shape how you feel about things is on the more important end of the spectrum. Mm-hmm. But without a little bit of outreach to people, it's hard if you are getting hit from all sides by negativity from the outside, even if you are the most cheerful, shining firefly, shooting star on the inside. Mm-hmm. if you walk outside and people are hating on you and disrespecting you, if you're getting harassed in the workplace, there's only so much that you can do to shine from within.
Yeah.
So I'm happy that we're having this discussion right now because it's something that people need to hear.
Yeah. And specifically with that, the YouTuber that you were talking about, I occasionally make dumb YouTube videos. And I actually made a response video to her video because I remember I stupidly watched it and it made me so angry. And but that anger was quickly replaced with just like, I feel bad for this woman, because I think that when you lash out at people like that, because she was clearly pissed, like she is angry at people who are fat. And when you lash out like that, I think there's something going on with you.
Oh, yeah.
You feel the need to tear someone else down because you are struggling with something. So I had a lot of sympathy for her, honestly, in the end. And I hope that she figures out a better way to deal with that in the future. Because I think she hurt a lot of people with that video, for sure.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And, you know, yeah, she did. She really did. And we know that because of the outrage that happened once she put that out there. I think most of her videos were removed. But, you know, yes, I agree. Forgiveness, namaste to her. We hope you find some inner peace, because it's clearly more of an issue that's going on within her than it is about anybody else. So with that said, we brought up a key word, and that key word is respect, that everybody is due this respect. But interestingly enough, we can only really feel it when we feel it ourselves first, when the respect is coming within us, and we understand how to build that within us. So what would you recommend? I mean, for me and what I do within my client base, when we start first building respect, it's asking that first question, like, what is the first step that you can take to start sending some love in, or to start seeing some, or taking one positive step for yourself to feel better within your body? What would you recommend as some ways to start respecting yourself?
That is a really great question. I think, for me, the way it kind of started, you know, because everyone's a teenager and everyone goes through that phase of you just hate yourself. You hate the way you look, no matter what you look like.
Yeah.
Everyone goes through the awkward teen phase. And I think when I was coming out of that, what helped me get there was really focusing on the things that I did like about myself. I was always very bad at taking compliments, and I still am, but kind of recognizing compliments as compliments, mm-hmm. and really taking that and running with it. So I got a lot of people saying, oh, you have really beautiful eyes. And I was like, you know what I do? They're unique and they're a cool color and I like my eyes. And just kind of starting there and building on the things that you like about yourself and focusing on those instead of focusing on the things that you don't like about yourself. Because that's when you go down the rabbit hole.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. For me, one of the eye openers was I was taking some coaching with ultimate self-confidence guru and international burlesque superstar, world famous Bob. And she encouraged me to sit down and to take a dry erase board and to divide it into 5 sections with days of the week and write the things that I wanted to get accomplished on the left, like taking care of your home, job stuff, basic responsibilities. And she was like, no matter what you fill up with the other boxes, make sure self-care is one of the boxes, mm-hmm. and make sure that is the first thing that you accomplish. Like, if you don't check off anything else during the day. And originally that was very hard for me to grapple with, mm-hmm. because in my family, I grew up with a mom who felt like she had to give all of herself to everyone before she could take care of herself. And that's the same. They always say it's like putting the oxygen mask on yourself before you put it on the child. If you're on an airplane and the masks drop. Because I would see things like that as frivolous. I was writing off self-care as something that could be put aside. And really it's the most important thing. And so being able to prioritize that in a visual and kinesthetic way, to be able to write something on a dry erase board in a way that I was going to treat myself well that day and then check it off, that was huge. That was huge for me.
you know, there is such a power to when you write things out, when they come mm-hmm. out of your headspace and, you know, you visually can see them. They're like a mirror. So I couldn't agree with that more. You know, I have something I call very similar, like a what feels list, a what feels good list on my desk. And I have what feels good, what serves me, and what doesn't. Because when I felt more insecure or was at what I refer to as a war with myself, within my own body, I would be doing 9 times out of 10 all these activities that I didn't like on my what doesn't serve me list because I wasn't respecting myself. I didn't feel good about who I was. So I guess, you know, was punishing myself by doing, you know, toxic habits over and over and over again until I had to break the cycle, and it's up to us to do that. So when we get back, we're going to be talking about that cycle and, you know, how important it is to realize how much how you feel about yourself affects all the different aspects about your life and all the different aspects about, you know, what's going on, relationships, career, spirituality, you name it. All right. When we get back, more with the podcast ladies and more with Shine On Radio. Can't wait.
Mother, hello father, here I am at Camp Granada. Camp is very entertaining, and they say we'll have some fun if it stops raining. I went hiking with Joe Spivey, he developed poison ivy.
Almost everyone at some time in their lives ask themselves, what am I? Most of our questions are ego-generated and simply don't address the problem of our false self. It's time to relax your ego and embody your soul. Dr. Dan Cohen, neurologist, inventor, and author, has created tools to awaken, a new way to transform from who you thought you were into what you truly are. Visit toolstoawaken.com today.
The doctor is in. Tune in to the hit show, The Psychic Love Doctor, with host Deborah Lee. Deborah's life-affirming, highly perceptive reading method has taught Deborah how to zero in on specific problems with relationships, career pursuits, and current roadblocks to success and happiness. Join Deborah Fridays at 2 p.m. Pacific and for a special broadcast the second Thursday of every month at 11 a.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Shine On Radio. Find Your Shine with Kelly is the show that celebrates what makes you, you. Join co-hosts Kelly Wadler and Dr. Pat Basile as they break down how to brilliantly fuel and move your body and love what makes you shine. Kelly is a professional arts and wellness coach dedicated to helping brilliant women find their confidence, energy, self-love, and shine. Tune in to Shine On Radio with Kelly and find your shine on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Francine Vale is a being of light. She believes that all people of planet Earth are as well. As co-host of the Angel Healer radio show, Francine teaches you heart-centered ways to manifest healing on your own behalf and how to integrate love more fully into your daily life. Connect with your angels as you find your life flowing with ease and harmony. Walk the path of light with Francine and Dr. Pat Basile every month on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Do you want the freedom to spend more time with your loved ones? Travel the world? Live spontaneously? Get ready, because the Chip Justice Show is here. Hosts Dr. Pat Basile and Chip Justice can help you build meaningful success while embracing life. Living a life you love is the end game in this new, inspirational, and empowering show. Positive changes for a life you'll love. Tune in every month on TransformationTalkRadio.com and visit PositiveChangeInstitute.co for more information.
A word of caution, if you prefer the status quo and you are not interested in improving every aspect of your life, this book will trigger the shift out of you. The Truth is Funny, Shift Happens is available now. Author Colette Steffen brings the powerful knowledge and life-changing energy and empowerment from the radio airwaves to the pages of her new book. To get your copy in paperback or ebook, visit thetruthisfunny.com today.
daughter. Hello, father. Here I am at Camp Granada. Camp is very entertaining. And they say we'll have some fun if it stops raining.
How could you not be smiling after you hear that little ditty? So funny. Okay. Welcome back. I am Kelly Wadler. I am the founder of Shine On Radio and Shine On Movement, which is a coaching company and a radio show all about helping people celebrate who they are, what makes you you, and embracing and owning the skin you're in. So you can look me up and research Shine On Movement at shineonwithkelly.com, and then all my other info is right there. So shineonwithkelly.com. And then we have today the ladies of the podcast with us, Liza and Lillian. Can you just let us know again what's up, how we can reach you, and when your show airs?
Heck yeah. We have a website, www.thebodypodcast.com. And you can find us by that name on most social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. We're all up in there.
Yeah. And you can listen to us on iTunes. I hope that you subscribe. We're also on different apps like the Podcast Addict, if you happen to be an Android user like myself.
Yeah. We're on SoundCloud too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we're all over the place.
Cool. And anyone who's listening now must be a podcast lover because they're listening to the radio. So we hope that everybody tunes in. So more back on our topic of body positivity. So before the break, we were talking about how we can first start implementing and taking the steps we need to take in order to respect ourselves. Because as I mentioned, when we don't feel good about who we are and we don't feel good about the body that we're in, other things start to take on a negative effect. For example, when I was at my most insecure years, it really affected, one, my relationship to food. I began emotionally eating and binging. And two, with my relationship with guys. I am a heterosexual and I would, you know, accept all this toxic crappy love because that's what I thought and what I welcomed and what I thought I deserved. Mm-hmm. So it really does take a toll on you, just besides what you're hearing and feeling when you look at the mirror. It causes the opposite of a positive ripple effect in the rest of your life. So what would you say? Have you recognized that to be true in your own personal stories before you started embracing who you are?
Yeah, definitely. I had all the struggles with food and dabbled in eating disorders for a little while, and it was not fun. It was not fun. I would never want to go back there.
and for me, I've had complicated relationships with food as well, and with lovers as well. I remember. So I'm married now. My mother-in-law told me one time that we all have an opportunity to teach people how to love us. I think that I was doing that on a regular basis with everybody that I came in contact with, because I felt like I was apologizing with my body language all the time for taking up space, because I was uncomfortable with my body. Even in work environments, I was the first to say I'm sorry about things that weren't my fault. And I feel like I kind of taught people to step on me a little bit. We don't have full control about how people treat us. Mm-hmm. But if you reinforce someone over and over again, either looking past you or people have a hard time taking you seriously, I mean, whether or not that's your fault. And I found that the more that I'm comfortable with myself and the less that I really care in general what people think of me, the easier it is for me to navigate those waters and to get the respect that I feel like I deserve.
So beautiful. Because it is fair to say that, you know, you were both married women. I'm about to be married. But, you know, I remember a time, and I recently wrote a blog article about this, that I blame my body as the reason why I wasn't finding love. And it's so interesting that you bring up that quote about your grandma shared with you, you teach people how to love you. But really, my challenge then was I had to teach myself how to love myself first. And, you know, I think that's one of the keys. It's, you know, it's not – like, okay, once I say and I'm going to choose to love myself, that somebody's going to magically come, or that I have to completely love myself before somebody comes. It's just that choice that we keep talking about, that I'm going to choose to see the light. I'm going to choose to think differently, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Sure.
Yeah.
To the point of that you were just making about loving yourself, I do think it's important to at least come to a place of self-acceptance, or at yes. least neutrality, where you're not at war with yourself all the time. But I do know many people who came to self-acceptance and self-love because of the love someone else showed them. Mm. I don't know. We hear that a lot, right? You have to love yourself first.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is important. And for a lot of people, it is the first step. But I think that it can be a little bit problematic to tell someone, especially who's struggling with depression or body dysmorphia, where they're fully cut off with their true and intentional self, that they have to take that step before they can figure it out. Mm-hmm. And everybody's path is different, and it's interesting to hear the stories of people who have come to feel integrated because of the kindness and love and compassion that they have felt from someone else, whether it was a lover or just a friend.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, I'm married as well. And I actually met my husband in high school, which is super weird, but, we never talked about it, and it was never a huge presence in our relationship, but he loves my body and has always loved my body. And I do think that that was helpful for me on that path. I don't think it was the only reason I started to, you know, feel better about myself and accept myself, because it happened. We were so young that I was still in that, you know, messed up teen, just everything is awful mindset. But I, you know, it definitely was part of it, you know, having someone who loved me and accepted me for what I was. And so, okay, I don't have to worry about that aspect. Now I have to worry about myself and figuring myself out, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. And I love both of those sides of the spectrum there, you know? And I think, again, I keep bringing up this word choose. And whether it's you choose to find the love in with yourself, or you choose to believe or feel what someone else is giving you, it is the choice to make that I'm going to start welcoming it or finding it within myself.
Yeah.
Right?
And the idea of deserving, and that I think that whether you're getting love from yourself or someone else, there is a core that you have to feel like you deserve it, because mm-hmm. otherwise you'll just keep pushing it away.
Yeah.
And how do we do that?
Oh, gosh.
I actually want to bring up something. There's heuristics and neuroplasticity, to get like big fancy words. Heuristics are shortcuts that our brain puts into play to help protect us. So if we had a bad experience with something, our brain sort of reprograms itself to keep that pain away. But we can retrain our brains.
Yes.
So even if you are, I mean, many, many, many of us are coming from deep pain from when we were young and are trying to like scramble out of that hole for the rest of our lives. Mm-hmm. But neuroplasticity is the idea that you can change the way everything's connected by retraining your thinking. And that's one of the things that I mentioned in my TEDx talk about seeing body diversity. So being able to surround yourself with positive people and a positive community, and whether that means images that are body positive or people who can lift you up, I think that that's important and the first step in being able to feel like you deserve that respect and love.
Yeah, and it's a big part of the movement too, is getting different body types and people who look different, you know, kind of readily available out into the world, so that people see that and are not afraid of it, frankly. Yeah.
Representation and visibility.
Yeah.
You know, speaking of such, I think that's a perfect leeway to, when we get back from break, what we're going to talk about, which is visibility and social media and fashion and media in general, and what we're experiencing now and what our youth is experiencing now, and maybe how we can be the pioneers to make this positive change. So more with the podcast, ladies, and more with Shine On Radio when we get back right after this.
Yay.
Action. Oh,
Get into it for 2016. Do you want more prosperity, clarity, energy, and balance in your life? Join Lynn Brown now through March for one of her amazing workshops, each focusing on a key part of living your best life. For more information and to register for one of these amazing workshops, visit LynnBrownEvent.com. That's LynnBrownEvent.com. And get into it this 2016 with Lynn Brown.
On the cutting edge of the new mainstream, Christine Upchurch is passionate about bringing together science, psychology, and spirituality in a way that can be applied to our everyday lives for true transformation. The Christine Upchurch Show, stellar conversations to illuminate your journey, engages some of the most outstanding visionaries on the planet in lively dialogue to inspire you to become that bright light you're meant to be. Join Christine every Friday at 11 a.m. Pacific Time on KKNW, AM 1150, and Transformation Talk Radio.
Almost everyone at some time in their lives ask themselves, what am I? Most of our questions are ego-generated and simply don't address the problem of our false self. It's time to relax your ego and embody your soul. Dr. Dan Cohen, neurologist, inventor, and author, has created tools to awaken, a new way to transform from who you thought you were into what you truly are. Visit toolstoawaken.com today.
The doctor is in. Tune in to the hit show, The Psychic Love Doctor, with host Deborah Lee. Deborah's life-affirming, highly perceptive reading method has taught Deborah how to zero in on specific problems with relationships, career pursuits, and current roadblocks to success and happiness. Join Deborah Fridays at 2 p.m. Pacific and for a special broadcast the second Thursday of every month at 11 a.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Shine On Radio. Find Your Shine with Kelly is the show that celebrates what makes you, you. Join co-hosts Kelly Wadler and Dr. Pat Basile as they break down how to brilliantly fuel and move your body and love what makes you shine. Kelly is a professional arts and wellness coach dedicated to helping brilliant women find their confidence, energy, self-love, and shine. Tune in to Shine On Radio with Kelly and find your shine on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Awaken to your radiant, authentic self. For over 15 years, Soul Purpose Advocate Nancy Monson has been focused on leading change in the lives of those looking to live their true purpose. She is devoted to supporting people and living a soul-directed life every day. Let Nancy help you overcome fear, worry, and doubt. Visit everydayspirituality.com to learn how Nancy can be your Soul Purpose Advocate.
Welcome back to Shine On Radio. At our last segment, as I probably repeat ad nauseum every week, I get very sad when it's the last segment, but we are here with a very powerful, powerful show today, all about the body positivity movement. All right, we have Lillian and Liza, the founders of the Body Poscast, here. Before we continue diving in again for the last time, just let us know, ladies, how we can connect with you.
Sure. We've got a website, www.thebodypodcast.com. And that name, you can find us on most social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all that good stuff.
And you can also listen to the podcast on iTunes and Podcast Addict and on SoundCloud. So we have our fingers in all the pies.
Oh, yeah.
Yummy. Pie. Sounds good. Okay. And as you know, I am the founder, Kelly Ann Wadler, and you can find me on shineonwithkelly.com. As I know, I am like these two ladies. We love to connect with people. So please write us an email, hit us up on Facebook, you name it. We will totally be there to connect. We love meeting people all that are on this train as well, this body positive train.
Heck yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Awesome. Okay. So we're going to finish up with a conversation on what's going on in media, the fashion world, social media, and how that can affect, whether it's positively or negatively, our body image and how we feel about ourselves. As I know for my own personal story with it, I think that there's a quote I love. It's like, you know, comparison is the key to unhappiness. And mm-hmm. I think that people can easily put up on social media their big wins, which is great, and I love celebrating them, or what seems like to be what's perfection going on. But really, nobody's life is perfect. Beneath that is, you know, everybody's own challenges. So what would you say for the people that are listening about, you know, gaining a certain perspective about what we're seeing in terms of body image out on the social media and the fashion and the media platforms?
Yeah, I mean, I know that I love Instagram. Let's start with Instagram. I love Instagram. It's probably my favorite of the social medias. And Instagram is really interesting because it's this huge spectrum of gorgeous photography and then selfies. And I love it all equally. And I try to fill my Instagram, not only my own feed, but also like not only what I'm posting, but also my feed, like what I'm seeing from everyone else, with positivity. It's such a great tool. There are so many amazing body positive Instagrams out there. And if you just fill your feed with the good stuff, then you're going to log on Instagram and feel amazing.
Yeah.
And I love using it as a tool for that. And I know that, you know, there's the awful side of social media where basically what it is it's people are hiding behind this anonymity and saying awful things because they don't have to say it to your face. And honestly, I think the best way to deal with that in most cases is to just ignore it. If something really gets a bee in your bonnet, take a deep breath. And I think it's okay to take a deep breath and respond, because there is a part of it where it's like, well, but if you let this person continue to do that, they're going to continue to think that it's okay.
Right.
But for the most part, it's just, again, people who are having a bad day and want to tear somebody else down so that they're having just as horrible a day. And it's really hard, but you just have to delete it, ignore it, whatever mm-hmm. it is for the most part.
Yeah. Something that I need to make an actual plan for is to sort of limit my social media participation, because I go a little overboard. And I think for me, actually, that does come from a place of insecurity where I'm like, oh, if people like me, like Sally Field, like, oh, my God. But I find it's eating into my productivity. Something else that I always recommend all over the place is to remove the people from your feeds who are constantly bringing in negative energy and crummy stuff into mm-hmm. your life, mm-hmm. whether that means unfriending or blocking or just unfollowing or deleting comments that people might leave on your page that you're like, ah, that doesn't really go with my brand.
Yeah. But it's so amazing. Another one of the great things about social media is that because anyone can post, that means anyone can post. It means that there's a whole hashtag called F your beauty standards, where it's just, you know, women who are not quotey fingers, you can't see me, but I'm making quotey fingers, conventionally beautiful, are posting these amazing, gorgeous pictures. There's so much, again, with visibility is so important, and social media allows us to start there and work the visibility into higher platforms, like, you know, maybe more higher end fashion stuff and on television and movies and all that stuff. So I love social media.
Yeah.
It's dark places, but I love it.
I think that the key for me anyway is to make conscious decisions about how I use it and how I experience it.
Yeah.
Right. And you guys mentioned, you know, like something that might be beneficial is loading your feed with positive stuff, or getting on Pinterest and making boards that serve you for motivation or for inspiration. So, and kind of, purging out what doesn't serve or what makes you feel kind of yucky about yourself. Because you know what? You're right. Everyone's entitled to what they want to say. It's how we react about what we're seeing and whatnot. Okay, awesome. So tying that then even further into fashion world, we're seeing some breakthroughs.
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah.
Right? Barbie's changing. the Sports Illustrated cover. What are you experiencing that's going on with this movement when it comes to the biggest pressure, or what once was the biggest pressure to be a certain size from the fashion world?
For me, I'm ignoring most of the mainstream retailers right now and going for boutiques who are actually caring about, I felt very alienated from fashion for a long time because I was like, well, none of that stuff is for my body. There are designers like Elise D'Alessandro with Ready to Stare, who's committed to using larger bodies. Mallory Dunn of Smart Glamour, who she, designs for size zero to, I believe, 26 or 30, and it's all the same clothes. You can buy the same dress if you're a size zero or if you're a size 20, which is what I wear. And I just bought something from her and I'm super excited to get it. And Crystal Bujan of Curvy Girl Lingerie, which I believe is the only plus size lingerie store, like brick and mortar store in America. Like, these people are pushing through boundaries, and thankfully folks are coming up behind them and supporting them.
Yeah.
Because that's a big problem.
Yeah. It's I keep saying it's a slow climb, but we're getting there, and you're seeing a lot more kind of non-straight sizes happening in more mainstream companies. And I think we'll get there. We'll get there where it's not a thing anymore. And that'll be amazing.
Yeah. And also, I think that more companies are designing for different shapes of bodies, which is amazing. But there's, I mean, it's not, we're not there yet, but there, we got to support the little people.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. I love that. You know, the grassroots effort that are starting small, and they do exist. And they're usually, I know a couple of those women that you just brought up that, you know, they are such wonderful, inspiring, you know, individuals themselves. So, okay. In the last minute, I want a couple sentences from the both of you. And my question is this: if, you know, anyone who's listening, you know, young, old, wherever they are in their relationship to their body, what would be one sentence of wisdom or your recommendation of their process to celebrating who they are?
For me, it's got to be everybody is beautiful. Every body is beautiful. Find the thing that you love about yourself and focus on that and ignore the rest.
Yeah. And for me, you are enough.
Ooh.
You're enough. That's it. You're enough.
And you know what I would add on to that is you are enough and you're also not too much.
Hey.
Oh, that is true.
For me, it was a lot of feeling like I was too much. Mm-hmm. With that said, this is Shine On Radio. Liza and Lillian, thank you so much for being here.
Oh,
thank you so much for having us.
I can't wait to be on your show. We're here at Shine On Radio every Monday at 12 p.m. Eastern Time, 9 a.m. Pacific. We will see you back here next week. Thank you so much for listening and have a great day. Shine on, all.
You've been listening to Shine On Radio. Find your shine with Kelly Wadler. This hit show celebrates what makes you, you. Join Kelly each Monday at 12 p.m. Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, as she breaks down how to brilliantly fuel and move your body and love what makes you shine. Kelly is a professional arts and wellness coach dedicated to helping brilliant women find their confidence, energy, and self-love. To learn more about Kelly, visit shineonwithkelly.com and tune in next week.